Welcome back to Shexa's YouTube channel. Today I'm going to discuss with you about the internet and all types of networks that the most common types of networks that we have. This is part two of this series of videos. Please make sure you watch part one, where I define what a network is from a node up until we get to wide area network, which is the internet. So today I'm going to take you through other types of networks that we have, that we may have. So please watch the video from start to the end. And as I said, networks and the internet, please give me a like if you like the video so that I get motivated. Give me a comment, share with friends, and subscribe. If you subscribe, you will never miss a video. YouTube will recommend it for you. So the first type of network that we want to talk about is personal area network. From the term itself, it's saying personal area network, so it's personally mine, it's personally yours, it's personally somebody else's network. So it's owned by one person, and when it's owned by an individual, most probably it's very small. So this is the smallest and the most basic type of network. A PAN is made up of a wireless modem. It's made up of wireless modem, a computer or two, phones, printers, tablets, and so forth. And they revolve around one person in one building. One person in one building. And the technologies that can be used include SharedIt, Bluetooth, mobile hotspot, Wi-Fi, and so forth. These types of networks are typically found in small offices or residences, and are managed by one person or organization from a single device. Wherever you are sharing a network with whenever a single device is sharing network to other devices, you can call that a personal network, personal area network. So for example, we have that one, or we can have that one with wireless, and we can also have that one where we have a laptop sharing with mobile devices, desktop, and a printer. So that's a personal area network. Now we look at a local area network. Local area networks connect groups of computers and low voltage devices together across short distances. Short distances within a building, or between a group of two or three buildings in close proximity to each other. And these connections are done to share information and resources. Enterprises typically manage and maintain local area networks. So these are the examples of local area networks that you can see. These are the computers connected to each other. We have the server here, and these other computers are connected in that way. And the next video that I'm going to prepare for you is about topology. So this one is more like a circular topology. Then we go to the next network, and these computers are within one building or several buildings that are close to each other. Same applies to that, same applies to that. So that's it for local area network. So that's it. Let's go to the next one, which is wireless area. Wireless is wireless local area. Wireless. It's wireless local area network. So that's it. Wireless local area network. So wireless local area network, it functions like LAN. But now wireless local area networks they make use of wireless network technology such as Wi-Fi. They are typically seen in the same types of applications as local area networks. It's only that they now have the term wireless. These are local area networks, but they are using wireless technology. These types of networks don't require that devices rely on physical cables to connect to the network. They use wireless technologies. The devices are connected to each other, but without any tangible physical cable connecting these devices together. So that's wireless or local area network. And then we have a campus area network. These ones they are larger than local area networks, but smaller than metropolitan networks. And metropolitan networks, we are going to discuss it next. These types of networks are typically seen in universities, large K-12 school districts, or small businesses. They can be spread across several buildings that are fairly close to each other, so users can share resources. Resources, we mean they can share printers, they can share memory and storage devices and so forth. So these are campus area networks. This is an example, number one, example number 20, some number three. You can see building one, building two, building one, building two, building three, building four. And these networks, the devices in these buildings, they are connected to each other. Same applies to that network. So that's campus area network. And the next one is metropolitan area network, MEN. These types of networks are larger than LANs, but smaller than wide area network. And they incorporate elements from both types of networks, from LANs and from wide area network. Metropolitan area networks span an entire geographic area, typically a town or a city, but sometimes a campus. For example, we have a network in Chinoy, which is being provided by Tier 1. So that Tier 1 network is what we are calling metropolitan area network. We can have ZOL covering maybe Harare, or maybe covering only Makoni Shopping Center. That ZOL network covering that geographic area is called the metropolitan area network. Then we have the ownership and maintenance, which is handled by either a single person or a company. Usually local council takes care of this. A large company like Tier 1, like I said, it can take care of these networks. So these three are the examples of metropolitan area networks. We have that one covering all this area, and this one covering all this area, and the other one. So this is metropolitan area networks. All right, let's now look at the next one, which is the wide area network. Wide area network. This one is slightly more complex than a LAN. A wide area network connects computers together across longer physical distances. Excuse me. This allows computers and low voltage devices to be remotely connected to each other over one large network to communicate even when they are miles apart, kilometers apart, and so forth. The internet is the example, or the most example, example of a wide area network. So computers in Zimbabwe, computers in America, computers in Malaysia, computers in Saudi Arabia, whatever, wherever these computers are located, they can communicate with each other. So this is one example of LAN, where we have LAN, and these LANs are connected to each other. Same applies to that, same applies to that, same applies to that network. So that's wide area network. Let's now talk about the storage area network, SAN. The SAN is just having a dedicated high-speed network that connects shared pools of storage devices to several servers. These types of networks do not rely on a LAN or WAN. Instead, they move storage resources away from the network and place them into their own high-performance network. So it's just a network, a single network, where we have storage devices, you see. So it's a network of storage devices. But now the area that is being covered contains or consists of only storage devices. And another network, which we can call local area network, can have access, can access these storage devices, these storage devices which exist in a storage area network. They can be accessed in the same fashion as the drive. We are having maybe I can have my memory card or big flash drive that is located at home. Maybe let me say Chiredzi, it's in Chiredzi and I'm here in Chinoy. I can access that that storage device while I'm here, and I will access it as if it's in my laptop or it's in my desktop or it's in my mobile phone. So that's storage area network. So these are the two examples of storage area networks. Here we have our storage devices, which can now be, which are in their own storage area network. Same applies here, we have storage area network with storage devices. And these computers, they are the ones that are accessing these storage devices, as if these storage devices are installed on their machines. We have the same here. These ones are the ones that are accessing these machines. These are storage devices, but these storage devices appear as if they are within these computers. Now let's look at the virtual private network, which was mostly used this other year when the internet was closed in Zimbabwe. Right, so by extending a private network across the internet, a virtual private network lets its users send and receive data as if their devices were connected to the private network, even if they are not. You see, so we are saying a private network, a virtual private network, lets its users send and receive data as if their devices were connected to the private network, even if they are not. Though a virtual point-to-point connection, this virtual private network, it allows one to connect to another network, and that person who connects to that other network appear as if the person is physically in that location. So through a virtual point-to-point connection, users can access a private network remotely. So he's saying this is the user, and this user is getting through a local network and getting through a public network, which is the internet, and then gets into a local area network and then access this server. But this person is accessing this server as if this person is located in this local area network. Let's look at another example. We have this one. This user, and that user. These users, they are getting into this network, and they appear as if they are physically located in this network. So this is how a user is connected to this local area network. There is a tunnel, goes through and gets into the local area network. So that's a virtual private network. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe. There are more networks that are available that one can actually make use of, and let me just add maybe two so that you can go and look at those networks. We have enterprise private network, and we also have passive optical local area network, and these are more networks that you can look at And if you look at the description, you can have you will see the description of these kinds of networks. You also have system area network. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share with colleagues and friends, family members, so that they enjoy learning IT with Shelter. Goodbye, enjoy the rest of your day.